Women's doubles is our next offering. Kamilla Rytter Juhl and Christinna Pedersen up against Ava Lee and Paula Lynn Obanana. What to play for now at one apiece, Dean?
Yeah, this match is only going to go one way, and that's Denmark's way.
You're confident on this one?
Totally.
Yeah, well, Rytter Juhl and Pedersen, one of the world's best doubles pairs around at the moment. You know, Obanana certainly will have their work cut out to make a match of this one. But obviously, coming up after that is the young Dane Kiersfeldt against Subandi. And the other doubles match, are you as confident of?
Actually, I'm quite confident that Denmark is going to take a 3-1 lead. I think this latest doubles, I'm actually absolutely sure that Denmark will win, but I'm also quite confident that Line Kiersfeldt will beat Subandi. As we saw her yesterday, she wasn't exactly in the same class as the two Wang sisters.
So there are Kamilla Rytter Juhl and Christinna Pedersen. Ava Lee and Paula Lynn Obanana. Rytter Juhl and Pedersen. Certainly a formidable pair, world rank number 5. Referee and umpire for this game is Steve Cheng of Hong Kong. Nice catch.
Yes, sir. Okay, you are Christinna. Okay. Obanana. Okay, which one? Okay.
You can see on the right arm of Ava Lee that the Olympic qualification period has been a tough one to get through.
Yeah, they just missed out on their qualification for the Olympics. They were second in the Pan Am ranking. Alex Spruce and Michelle Lee, number one, they qualified. And Denmark were unsure whether to take Rytter Juhl and Pedersen to the Olympics. Thought it might affect their mixed doubles, but you were telling me earlier, Steen, they made a decision before they flew out to Wuhan.
Yeah, they've decided to let them play two categories in the Olympics. And it's always a good question whether it will affect positively or negatively. And, after the Olympics, we'll know if they get a medal. It's been positive. If not, it's been negative.
Well, here's Paula Lynn Obanana. As you can see, a pretty positive win-loss ratio. They won a recent event in Tahiti just a month ago, runners-up in the Swedish International, the Austrian International, and the Polish International. So they're used to winning matches. 30th in the world. A couple of wins for them last year. They won the bronze in the Pan American Games. Yeah, it's an interesting decision that has to be made. I mean, Christinna Pedersen here was saying, you know, during the qualification period, it hasn't affected us negatively. You know, we've been doing well in both disciplines, so why should it during the Olympics?
Yeah, but there's also both their playing partners in mixed doubles, Joachim Fischer and Thomas Laybourne, have been injured from time to time, and having the ladies' doubles still playing, still having tournaments to look forward to, has been good for them, no doubt about that. At the Olympics, it's a little bit different this time, as there's group play. First time ever in the Olympics that there's group play in badminton, so you get to play a lot of matches, and I think that the doubles competition at the Olympics will be considerably stronger than the singles, so it might be quite tough matches, even from the beginning. So of course, it's reasonable to consider what to do instead of just automatically selecting the players in two categories.
Representing Germany, Dieter Dongfeng. Representing United States of America, Paul Borshu.
Well, both these American ladies, born outside of that country. Ava Lee born in Hong Kong, Obanana born in the Philippines. What is the strength of Pedersen and Ruhl, and what makes them such a good pairing?
First of all, they're very good tactically. They're able to read their opponents well and carry out tactics in the game. And of course, they're both very tall players, so they have quite good attacks. They're good with the racket, really fast racket movement. They can create
Ladies
points.
And gentlemen,
both players can
right,
create points by Denmark. Themselves, and that's, in my opinion, really, really, really important in
and Christina Patterson.
International ladies doubles.
On my left, United States of America. Rytter Juhl
very
and
well.
Paula Lynn, Obanana. Christina to serve to Paula.
Well, 1 point apiece now.
Level play.
The Danes, big favourites in this women's doubles.
One love.
Last outing saw them take the European title, Pedersen and Juhl. Their compatriots, Kruse and Rukke, in that one.
Hot. Service over. 1-0.
We will have fourth match of Thomas Park, Group C, men's doubles in court two. Representing Malaysia, Hung Hung Han, Kim Ki Koo.
There we saw some of the strong points from the Danes, able to set up the attack, and both players follow up on the front court.
Service over, 2-0.
Short service from Obanana, and immediately punished by Juhl.
Just going back to that Olympics point, and if they had said no, that was good, by the
service
way.
Service over. 3-0.
3-0 now. If they had said no, it'd been rather dispiriting, wouldn't it, for the ladies?
Yeah. Yeah, and that also might have been the environment
over.
For the next couple of
Four.
Months. Up to the Olympics might not have been as good as it is now. And it also, on the positive side, it could give you some security knowing that you play two categories. So if you should miss in the one, you still have a good chance in the other one. I think that started actually on the line,
Five,
but
three.
Sort of
missed by a long way in the end, didn't it?
Yeah.
That was the drift taking its effect.
Sort of in control from the beginning of the match here, quite as we expected.
Diana here at the back of the court. Very much the focal point of this rally, though. Now in it for America.
Good call.
Seven,
we can see in the beginning of this rally, Obanana was smashing a lot of times from the back court, and the Danes were in totally perfect defense position, so there was really nothing to gain from smashing in those positions.
Just the start the Danes would have wanted here.
Service over, 4-8.
Good service return from Obanana, just putting it below the tape.
Six, eight.
Surprising miss that from you.
Yeah, there's been a couple of mistakes. Starting with the service return, which he put in the net, and then one long, and now this one. So it's time to gear up a little bit.
Well, after being very much in control, a few errors have slipped in from the Danes, and suddenly it's at 8-all. that helps their cause.
Service over. And nine.
Actually, a lot of players could learn from this, that if you don't play at 100%, then you're suddenly not as much better than the opponent as you believe.
Yeah, that goes for any sport really, not just in badminton, but
exactly.
10-8.
A wake up call.
Well played by
service over.
The Americans here.
9-10.
Showing great patience and control.
There's the Danish power that takes them into the interval with a 11-9 lead.
Interval.
Det var rigtig god til i starten, det var han, der hvis de lige rev en over, og vi var lidt ude af balance, så spiller vi bare et simpelt slag. Og der er det i midten der vil I gerne lave noget på den stadigvæk. Og så at de får chancen for at spille kontra. Enten bare stoppe den, eller også køre den op over dem. De har ikke slået en igennem os endnu. Okay. Så spille med dem og hold det simpelt. Og så...
Ja,
behøver
vi ikke, at vi har lavet det første slag på defensiv. Bare lægge en op i skiver, så
ja. Der er den ene duel, hvor I får kørt den lidt på din side og sådan noget. Det er fint. Du skal bare være klar på, at alle deres slag kommer højt, så I skal være klar heroppe omkring, ikke?
Ja. So, here comes our translator, Steen. Tell us what Lars was saying there.
Yeah, so they started out really good, and then in the middle of the game, they sort of wanted to do too much without really having the chance to do it on the right, the correct position to do it. So instead of trying to do too much, then just play a little bit more patient, let the Americans do the work, quite good in defense, but exactly that shot
service
was
over.
One that Lars warned the girls
ten,
about. That,
11.
That the American offense is a bit flat, so they have to raise the rackets a little bit. The Danes are sort of waiting for very, very steep smashes, and that's just not going to happen.
Over. 12, 10. Service over. 11, 12.
Long, but that was a bit Service lucky
over.
For the Danes again.
13,
so
11.
Tried to do too much again in a no chance situation.
Service over. 12, 13. Service over. 14, 12.
I think Danish girls should try to raise the speed a little bit, be a little bit more concentrated and finish this off a little bit quicker than they might do now. That was long. That
Service
quick
over.
Serve from Pedersen
13,
here.
14.
Yep.
You can see the way they walk around the court, it's sort of slow movements. I think they feel pretty confident that they're going to win this match. But
well, you certainly were.
Yeah.
14-0.
But it's 14-0 now.
Yeah, but they've made probably 12 mistakes, so...
No, I take your point, but as you say, you know, even if you are world number five, you've still got to be playing 100%
yeah,
shots
exactly.
like that,
yeah.
otherwise you're not going to win the points.
You actually, a lot of players try to save a little bit of energy and power when they feel that they can win the match, but they end up using more energy and power because it's going to be tight and you're going to be using psychological energy, so
15,
to speak.
14.
Never mind, you're playing more points.
Yeah. And then of course there might be this that. The first match that the Danes play in the hall and the Americans played yesterday, so their timing might be a little bit better, but
and some credit as well to Lynn and Obanana here.
Over.
You know, they're playing pretty
15,
well.
Yeah.
16.
They're raising their game.
They are.
You know, as I say, they come here with some confidence with the wins that they've produced over the last year or so. Disappointment obviously in not qualifying for the
16,
Olympics.
All.
Marina Wang, who we saw early on, the only female who'll be representing America at the Olympic Games.
'17-16.
It's not exactly boosting your confidence from the Danes' point of view.
They're behind now. Jorgensen's defeat
17
to Iris Wang was a bit of a surprise. This would be a huge turn up for the books if Obanana and
there will be no surprise, but it will be perhaps a little bit tougher than I expected in the beginning. But the Danes will win.
18-17.
Well, they're ahead again now.
Oh!
got it right 19, this time, the flick serve.
17.
Very, very good server, Pedersen. Sort of put it in all positions.
And 20, suddenly game points have arrived. 17. Thanks to 4 points in a row. One save.
Service over. 18-20.
Well, it's 19, tighter still.
20.
Well, credit to Obanana and Lee. They're going toe-to-toe here with the world number fives. A little bit of anxious looks on the Danish coach's bench. And it's now 20 all.
That was a really, really good shot all. From Obanana. Exactly the right placement. And now it's all down to luck.
And into extra points. Two clear points required. Game point again for Denmark.
Service over. 21-20.
Given a bit of a fright, but Denmark do take the opening game 22-20.
22-20.
Credit to Lynn and Obanana. They really gave it everything, even saving a couple of game points there at the end too. But it is the first game to Denmark, and they'll be hoping to push on from there.
Cannot return, you just go both sides first. Okay. Both sides from the defense, stop okay. From the defense. No mistake for the immediately for the receive service, okay? Second, you're netting good, you set up very good today. With teamwork, you in front, set up. You better than other side, better, remember. And then hit right, open it up, you attack. These are the good team for ours. Okay, you set up, soft. You soft the better than other side. But sometimes you go both sides, when you're defense, how to push. Okay, almost close, way close, play so good today.
We heard the American coach emphasizing that the Americans should avoid making mistakes in the service situation.
Eva, is it? Should we sit? Okay.
As we see caught the statistics
one,
here,
second.
We can see that
caught one, 20 second.
Danes had four more overhead winners than the Americans. The rest was quite even.
Second game.
It'll be interesting to see here in the second game whether the Danes can sort of
Love
increase all. The pace
right.
Or the Americans can continue to play well and sort of take the control.
Service over.
Rush here by Pedersen, but
Love.
Put it wide.
Over. 1-0.
Danes have some difficulties in getting the right timing in their overhead shots.
It was tight in the first game, and it looks like it's going to be tight in the second as well. Court called on the serve.
2-4. Out. Service over. 5-2.
Given all the bandages and the strapping there for Ava Lee, you wonder whether she can actually swing the racket, but all there for protection, one assumes.
3-5.
Very strange match.
What do you mean by that, strange match, Steve? Because, I mean,
it's the intensity. There is rallies, but the intensity is almost gone. I mean, it's like they're waiting for someone to shout at them. Come on, let's play now.
Hot. Service over.
I mean, yesterday the this pair were really swept aside by Fuji and Kakawa. It was 21-8, 21-9. You wouldn't have seen this coming, would you?
This way.
That's better.
Service over.
From a Danish point of view.
5-6.
First time in a while that the Americans hasn't succeeded getting out of the defense.
Service over. 7-7.
Absolutely impossible to return for Christinna Pedersen, but it was actually what Coach Chai warned the American pair of doing.
Seven.
Do not take too many risks on short services.
Very short, I was going to say rallies, they're not even rallies, are they?
No.
Serve, that's it.
And we saw Christinna rushing towards the net here and sort of putting pressure on the Americans, but Kamilla was staying back, not helping her, and the Americans get out of the trouble. ending up winning the rally.
Wow. 11-7. Who would have predicted this? First of all, the first game struggles. That took its extra points. And now the Americans have an 11-7 lead here in game number two. Are we heading for another three-gamer?
Sure. It's not really. Okay? So key point is pay more attention to serve, receive, serve. And then second, when we defense, how release turn to attack. Release meaning is a way, soft, hard, back, front. How to see the release perform. And then attack, attack. If you have a chance, push the body.
So fill us in then, Steen. I mean, it's quite animated in the Danish camp, as you'd expect.
Yeah, Lars was coming in saying that we need to gear up, and I totally agree. And Kamilla and Christinna said that they were not feeling confident on court, and I also agree to that, because it's obvious that they're not feeling confident. But
I mean, just, I mean,
11-7
from a professional perspective, you just sometimes turn up on a court one day and, you know, you have different feelings now. Sometimes it goes for you, you feel heavy leg, the racket's not moving in the way you want it to move. And
yeah, definitely, but it started out quite well until 8-3, and then there was some stupid mistakes, four in a row, and suddenly it was an even match. And there's some things that you could do. I mean, you could smash a bit more, force yourself to go forward, move faster. This is a good rally, both sides playing well.
Oh, clash of rackets between the Danes there, still in the rally though.
Well, that's more like it.
Service over 13-8.
That's a very nice 5-point lead the Americans have here.
And they're following the coach's advice on the service returns, to play them to the side and don't risk anything. As it is at the moment, the Danes will create the points for you.
Service over. 9-13.
Able to capitalize on it.
We will have the fourth match of top class group D, men's doubles.
11-13.
Representing Germany, Michael Kumpers. Representing Germany, Oliver Ross. Representing United States of America, Philip Schultz.
Comfortable smash for Pedersen, and 5-point leads down to two now.
Good service.
12-13.
Where Obanana expected, and that sort of paved the way for a mistake.
Service over. 14, 12.
Yeah, She did well there in Bunyana, didn't she?
Really good defense by Bunyana there.
Representing Malaysia, Bisha Gold, Kim Wai Ping. Representing South Africa, Prakash Diyamaja, Jacob Maliaka.
Just
when you thought the Danes were just going to start gaining control of this match again, it starts to slip again. Rally.
Extremely well played. Really well played by
18,
the American side 12. Here, controlling everything, moving faster than the Danes.
Wow, what an intriguing match this is turning out to be. 1-0, but it could be one game all in the third.
Yeah, I just think it's going to be a decisive game now. It's too big a lead to catch up on. There was a sign of Juhl changing gear.
18. Film, please.
In the lead, trying to catch the attention of the umpire.
Good time for the Americans to take a break, really. Just lost a couple of points and, you know, they're only a few points away from making it 1-0.
We can't see it in the picture here, but Eva Lee is close to the coach behind the court.
14, 18. Service over.
From watching 19, these pictures, you can't 14. Tell who is number 5 in the world and who is ranked number 30. Or is it 24?
No, 30, you're right, yeah. There's 25 places between them in the world rankings, but as you say, you wouldn't know it. And it's game 20, points
game
to the American pair
14.
Of Eva Lee and Paula Lynn Obanana. Chance to make it 1-1. There you go, it's long, and it is 1 point apiece after the first two singles. It's now one game apiece in the women's doubles.
21-14, one game all.
Well, It's a huge turnout for the books. I think we shouldn't make any predictions for the final game.
I will. The Danes will win.
It's a risky business given the way you said it would pan out at the start, Steve.
Discussing that the Americans probably got a little bit better feeling, got a better touch for the hole here, but otherwise than that, as far as I'm concerned, they got the right plan. The Danes, they want to avoid taking these stupid chances from below the tape. Just put it close to the baseline instead of trying to play a creative shot.
Court one, 20 seconds. Court one. 20 seconds.
Well, here's some of the stats.
Play, please.
Well, honors even all round here. Pedersen and Juhl given a real fright here by Lynn Obanana.
Christinna, are you full receive? You receive okay? Okay. Final game. La ball. Play.
Well, no doubt there was some surprise yesterday when the Netherlands, hold on, there's a shuttle on court here from the match between Germany and Australia next door. Okay, we can start again. I was saying that there was a bit of an upset yesterday, the Netherlands beating Chinese Taipei.
But
I would say
one
if Lino Bunyana beat Rytter Juhl and Pedersen, it would be the biggest shock of this BWF Thomas and Uber Cup so far.
Really well played by Eva Lee here, who took the rush towards the net and created the opportunity for Obanana to win it.
Service over. 2-1.
Break. The Danes, that's how to do it. And also from a tactical point of view, I think they should aim the smashes a little bit more at Obanana because he's not as confident playing on the front court as Eva Lee is.
Service over.
Terrible outcome.
4.
Another mistake from Pedersen. You can see she's just getting a little frustrated with herself. Many of these errors now are costly.
Seven.
they're struggling now, and I mean, they have to realize that the way they played the two first games, they're going to struggle now. So there's not going to be any easy points or great play. It's hard work now, and the beginning is doing the right things. Now the next thing they need is to do them at the right pace and push up the speed.
Chase speed.
And quite a crucial time of the game right now, because they've gotten this 3-4 point lead. So, but they need to make it bigger, because otherwise they might fall asleep again.
Service over. 4-7. Service over. 8-4.
Really good smash placement by Paula Lynn Obanana.
What went on there? Just kind of left it to each other here, didn't they?
I think it's normally one of the situations where the Americans would change so that Eva Lee will move towards the net. Unfortunately for her, Obanana read it otherwise. That's it.
Well, that's a nice lead now, isn't it, for the Danes? 6 points. They're ahead now going into the interval. And it seems like normality has been restored in this match.
Exactly. It seems like normality has been restored, but it's not. And it's important now that Lars sort of keeps the Danes fired up now.
Well, now he cannot kill. Can you sometimes solve the smash? Not the same power smash. Sometimes you clear to the middle. Let opponent attack first. We return the attack. Okay? Not like you hot. You lost the position. Opponent other side. We miss it. Sometimes you change the power to down. If you cannot, you play to the middle. Middle opponent attack. Not open. He cannot kill us. Is it change the way? Not only one.
Okay.
And the Eva, I believe. Not so. It's good. Netting good. So you must close Eva.
I totally agree with Chai Zimin that the Americans would benefit from varying their attack a little bit. If they're not able to kill it, just put a clear in the middle. It's always good advice in ladies' double.
Yeah. 11-5. Play.
From the Americans here now. Been a great effort from them.
Service over. 6, 12.
One serve from Pedersen.
Seven, 12. Obanana, but it's a strange serve. It looks like she's almost she lost the shuttle and had to flick it.
It's long.
8, 12.
It's a little deception. But too much power.
Oh, wasn't by much, was it? Very close call.
That's it.
Service over. 13, 8.
Well, there'll be some relief in the Danish camp. Yeah, but they come through this.
Yeah, and the last two or three rallies, they've been playing more like they want to play.
Oh! 15, 8.
From Obanana. How can it lead to something? Oh, it can. Yeah. And she's the one that finishes it off. She deserves the applause.
She lost a hairband during the rally.
She decided to redo her hair while we're watching this. Moment or two, isn't it, for the Danish pair in this game. But, that shows a lot of the fighting spirit between these American duo. Obanana getting the point that, well, keeps them just about in the hunt here, although at 15-9.
Two or three easy points and they're back in.
Service over. 16-9.
This just illustrates what we discussed in the first game, that the Danes are actually going to use more power playing three sets than they would have if they'd geared up in the first and followed up in the second.
That's it.
Service over. 10-16.
Lee makes her way to the net. Excellent play.
Good play all around. Obanana puts it in the net.
Service over.
Denmark edging closer to the crucial point.
Thank you.
points from victory now, Denmark here.
Taking
this to a third game, the Americans, but now they're staring 10 match points for the Danes right in the face. It's good, and that is the match. Comfortable in the end for Denmark, but boy, they were given a fright by Nivali and Paula Lynn Obanana. Went all the way to this third game. In the end, they took it 21-10 in the decisive one.
Match won by Denmark, 22-20.
Select the player of the match. 14, in my opinion, it would be Eva Lee, who played really well. And the positive note for the Danes is that they finished off quite well, so they can take some confidence with them.
So tomorrow. The world number five pair get the job done in the end. And Steen's going to exit the commentary box. We look at the stats there, and you can see it was the winners from the net. They just about shaded it, Rytter Juhl and Pedersen. So it was a well fought match from Lee and Obanana. So that victory for Rytter Juhl and Pedersen gives Denmark a 2-1 advantage in this best of five Uber Cup group stage.